Hi, it's Ken McElroy. So thanks for watching. As you guys know, we get lots of questions from our subscriber community. And one of the questions that continually comes through from a lot of different people are the various types of mistakes for small business owners or entrepreneurs. And so there's a lot of mistakes. And so I started putting together a list, and the list can be big, but I narrowed it down to the top five. So here they are. So I think the number one thing that most entrepreneurs do is that they focus on the money too much. And so they focus on the raise or the money that they need for a property or for a business or for an opportunity. And a lot of times I find that they're not really passionate about the business. In other words, they're trying to make money. There's nothing wrong with that, but they don't really care. And so sometimes I've seen people take a property and put a social component to it, or a business and add a social component to it or whatever. But you know, all of a sudden it generates some kind of purpose. But I think what I've found is that most successful entrepreneurs, and I've interviewed a lot of them, almost never ever focus on the money. And I know it's hard to understand when you're sitting there and you're trying to grow a business, but trust me, if you're passionate about something, you'll make it, you'll figure it out. The second thing I believe is that they expect immediate success. And I think a lot of time entrepreneurs are quick starts, or they're fast and they're salespeople, and you know, they want things to happen quickly. And so I think expecting success right away is another really big problem that most people have. And there's a process, there's a natural evolution with people, with clients, with businesses, with you know, your sales and your and maybe your customers and all those things. There's a natural process. And in other words, when you make the decision to start a business, it doesn't mean that everybody else has made the decision to use you. And so there's a long time period. And so whatever you think it is, in my opinion, just double it. The other thing is that they always try to do everything themselves. And so you see this a lot. You know, probably the biggest example is a doctor or a dentist or maybe a realtor, where, you know, that essentially they have their own practice, let's say, or their own service like a realtor. Everything has to go through them. They're very controlling and they don't delegate at all. So there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with starting that way, and that's almost actually how you have to start. But in order to get bigger, in order to get to scale, you have to start dishing off things that don't benefit you financially. In other words, they keep you to grow your company or your business and have some of the menial things like the phone calls and the accounting and some of the things that are really important in a business. You should not be doing those. You should be doing everything what we call rainmaking. You should be only growing sales and only growing income. And so a lot of times people get stuck here, and I see this is probably one of the bigger issues. Is they everything has to go through them, and so it limits the amount of things that they can do. They don't leverage their time, and there's no scalability, which is kind of the word that's used a lot. So this works a lot for like franchises. You know, that's why franchises work, because you know, somebody can buy a package, you know, buy a system and run it themselves, and they, you know, there's rules and all these things around it. But more of a freestyle entrepreneur has to learn how to do these kinds of things. One of the interesting things right now, and the younger people won't completely understand this, that is very interesting to me for people my age, is that, which is the fourth thing, is a lot of businesses don't use social media. And it blows me away how many don't use social media. And everyone basically is on social media for one reason or another, and all the different kinds. And we're not going to go into all those here, but when all your customers are online, essentially, there's no reason for you not to be promoting your business and promoting yourself and your services and things like that on social media. It's incredibly cheap, and it's a great way to expand your reach. And so there's a lot of people that are kind of stuck in their own mindset of the way things that used to be. And there's company after company after company, like Sears or JCPenney's or Kodak, or, you know, of real businesses that have stayed where they've stayed, and they haven't done anything, and they've flatlined or gone out of business. And then the fifth thing is most entrepreneurs have a tough time adapting. In other words, let's say they put together a business plan or, you know, a strategy or something, and then there's a curveball thrown at them in some way. And trust me, there will be lots of curveballs. And they have a tough time seeing it, understanding it, asking the right questions, even just adapting to what would be, you know, a new direction. You know, and so it happens all the time. It happens every single day. In other words, when I start off on a direction on some kind of project, invariably it gets halted. It takes a left. It takes a right. It goes down. It goes up. You know, and so what I found is sometimes when entrepreneurs have these fixed mindsets, that they have a really tough time. They're very rigid. They're very black and white. And entrepreneurship is not black and white. It has to be in some areas, but you have to expect all these different things that can come at you all the time, and you have to be willing to adapt. So hopefully you enjoyed the top five mistakes that entrepreneurs make and apply it to your own situation. And if you can, you can avoid some of these mistakes. Thanks for watching. If you have been making any of these mistakes and want to be sure you can avoid them in the future, then be the first to see my latest videos by subscribing to my YouTube channel. And visit kenmacroy.com to become a free member and access more of my premium content.